You guys, this is what I'm just so passionate about. This is what I have a huge heart for evangelism, for people to just have a strong rooted faith in Jesus Christ that is unwavering amidst whatever culture says, because they go up and down with whatever is acceptable, but God's word stays the same no matter what. Welcome to today's video. Today we're going to do something a little bit different. I thought it would be fun to do a little question and answer video so you guys could get to know me a little bit better, but I don't want this to just go one-sided. So as I talk, feel free to type in the comment section or wait till the end, whatever you feel like doing, and share with me something about you, because I'd love to get to know you guys better. Share with me like a fun fact about yourself. Or even if you want to go a little bit better, share with me a topic you'd like me to share about in a video at some point. So before we get into this video, if you are new here, my name is Molly and I make videos to help women uncover the lies of the culture and find hope and find fulfillment in Jesus Christ and just find that joy that I have found in Jesus. I share a lot about my experience of going through divorce and being a single mom and sharing God's goodness in that part of my story of my life. So if that's something you are interested in, I'd love to have you subscribe and join this little YouTube community. And if you've been watching my videos for a while now and you're like, I appreciate what Molly's doing, I support her desire to share the truth with others on a social media platform, and that's something you wanna support, I'd love to have you join my little Patreon, a little support family that support me in either $5, $10, $20 a month, whatever you're able to do. And I'm gonna link that down below. Right now I have two Patreons and I so appreciate you two people that are supporting me right now. I'd love to have that community grow a little bit so that I can invest more time in what I'm doing right now. Making videos, it does take quite a bit of work to even put out one video a week, but I would love to be able to invest a little bit more time in studying and making other content for you guys. So let's get into this question and answer video now. All right, first question, simple, easy question I was asked was, have I always lived in Washington State? So no, I have not, but I have lived most of my life in Washington State. I did, so the summer that I graduated from high school, I don't know if this counts as living somewhere because I was only there for the summer, but I'm gonna share it because it's fun to share. I lived in California for the summer working at a Christian conference center, and that was a really fun experience. I was quite homesick because it was the first time I had been away from my family for, over a month or whatever. I was gone for the whole summer, but I made some really good friends. I worked in the children's, like the child care department, and I love little kids, so that was a really fun experience. And then after that, I went to Bible school in Oregon, a one-year Bible school, and that was an awesome experience of growing in my faith, making friends, just having fun. It was at the beach. It's called Ecola Bible School where I went. Really good experience. And then I had the opportunity to come back a second year as an intern. So there was an internship program where we had classes certain days a week, but also our main goal of being there was we were on staff with certain responsibilities. So I was an RA for one of the girls' dorms, and I love that. That was like right up my alley of encouraging girls, spending time with them, going out to coffee with them, and just connecting with all these different personalities of girls, being there for them. So that was a really, really good experience. And I feel like actually that was a time in my life where it just highlighted something that God put in me to encourage women, to be so supportive for women and be a leader among women. So that was a really good experience for me. Then moving on to like adulthood, I lived in Alaska for a year when I was married with my former husband. And that's where he was raised. So we went and lived in the town that he grew up in. Totally different culture in Alaska, freezing. I didn't do too well with the cold. So many great people that lived up there though, in a very cool, like small knit community. One thing I loved about living in Alaska was it really coming from living most of my life in a town that is like more higher income town to moving to Alaska, I was able to see people just live within their means more, live more simply. And that's probably one of the biggest takeaways I took from my time up there, of just seeing that it's okay to live simply. It's okay to not have a lot. And I really appreciated learning and growing in that sense by living up there. So now I live in Washington State again. Never thought that I would stay here this long, but I live close to my parents, which is really helpful for me. So thankful for their support in my life. And I've got a great church family here as well. So next question was, what age did I become a Christian? So I actually have done a whole video on my testimony, and I will link that video down below sharing how I came to faith. But I was about 6 years old. I'm not going to give away the whole story and the big parts of my life that were impactful for my walk with God, because I want you to watch that video that I made. But that's a little teaser of my testimony. Okay, next question. And Marissa, thank you for asking this question, because guys, if you get me talking about three things, okay, Jesus and Christianity and culture, I love talking about that, but I also absolutely love talking about makeup, and three, I love talking about fashion. Those three things I could talk for hours on end about, and I love them. So Marissa's question was, what is my go-to outfit if I were just going out with friends for like a casual friends date? And I really, okay, so it changes per season, but I really am digging the sweaters, the high-waisted denim, the a midi skirts. Those are the styles I really like. I love a cute jacket, like a cute trench coat. I feel like jackets elevate a look a lot when you have like a sweater and then a jacket and a cool pair of pants and boots. I love boots because, okay, this is my key thing in winter, is I'm always cold. Always cold. So if I can look cute and warm, that's my ultimate goal. And I thrift everything. Most of my clothes are thrifted. I rarely ever buy brand new. I have some friends that sometimes will give me hand-me-downs, like these pants. Oops, you can see my socks, but these pants are hand-me-downs. And these two things are thrifted. But yeah, I would say my go-to outfit is like a nice sweater, jeans, or a skirt and boots for sure. I've been just getting into this year like wearing tights again more, so that I can wear skirts and I can wear dresses in the winter. And I'm just loving that. I'm loving being able to dress up more, because I feel like, okay, see, you could get me talking forever about fashion. I feel like in our society today, we've become much more casual and much more just chill with what we wear, which there's nothing wrong with that in and of itself, but also there's this element of laziness in our culture, like glorifying laziness and not taking care of ourselves and not looking appropriate for the occasion. And that's one thing when I think back to like my grandma's time and just looking at the styles that were in then, is that people wore things that were appropriate for the occasion more. Like you would wear a certain outfit for going to the beach, but then you wouldn't wear that beach outfit for going to church or even going out shopping. And I love that idea of wearing what's appropriate for the occasion and the situation. And so I've been trying to elevate my look a little bit more, but it's just crazy because when I go to stores and I look for dresses or things like that, there's so little amount of dresses, but there's so many like sweatpants and sweatshirts and all of that. So it's just super interesting, the phase that we are in of fashion in this time. All right, so my last question that I got was, what has been my biggest challenge during the pandemic? And I love this question because it gave me some time to just really think about this year and the challenges that like I faced and we've all faced, and really like reflect. And it brought to mind some fears and some anxieties that I have had during this year that I didn't really totally like verbalize to the Lord. So I actually spent some time and prayed about it and reflected on it. And that was really, really good. So I'm thankful for this question. So the biggest challenge for me, I don't think so much has been personally, because in general, like I've been struggling with anxiety and just how anxiety has affected my health the last few years, just with single parenting and going through divorce and all of that. So that hasn't really been a new thing, any personal struggles. There hasn't been any huge like new personal struggles that have come up in 2020. And thankfully, you know, I was able to keep my job. I did have to take some time off with work at the beginning of the pandemic, but God's provided for me financially, and I'm very, very thankful for that. I would say though that my biggest challenge during this pandemic has been fear for our country, for our country's freedoms, for our country in regards to its view of religious freedoms and its view of Christians, and just seeing a lot of things that were maybe a little bit under the surface, or maybe things I wasn't aware of as much, come to the surface. And really just, I feel like 2020 has been the year of almost like cracking things open, like cracking open this egg of like seeing things really for what they are. And there's been a number of Christian leaders this year come out and say, I'm not a Christian anymore. And there's been a couple of Christians come out even recently, that Christian leaders that some sin that had been hidden came to the surface. And those things always kind of really make me sad and shake me up a little bit. It's like, wow, like how could this have happened kind of thing. And what breaks my heart the most, and I've really had this burden on my heart, is for people that grew up in the church. Maybe they even went to Bible school with me, or yeah, they've had Christian parents and they've grown up in that surrounding. But now they're really becoming disillusioned to the gospel, and they're starting to have doubts about it, and they're starting to question Christianity. And I think the reason there's so many of these questions going on is because, I could do a whole video on this, so I'll say it really shortly, is because Christianity in general was commonly accepted in years past. It was like, yeah, everyone said they were a Christian now, and it wasn't a big deal. Now, was everyone actually having faith and a true follower of Christ? No, but it was culturally acceptable. Well, now we've entered in an age, and it's not just in 2020, it's been going on for a while, but it seems to be ramping up more, where Christianity is not accepted, and it's not common as much anymore, and it's becoming, I don't think it's fully there yet, but it's becoming the fact that Christians are seen as evil, and what Christians believe as unacceptable, as unloving, uncaring. And so there's this divide between culture and Christianity that's becoming greater. And I think so many young people are trying to reconcile the two and figure out how it can work together, and then feeling disillusioned by what Christians are saying and what culture are saying. And they're often choosing what culture is saying. And my heart goes out to them so much. I really want to reach out to those of y'all that are struggling with doubts about your faith and discuss some of those questions that you may have about Christians and Christianity as a whole. But I wanted to just read this verse because it came to my mind in regards to this topic. And it says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge because you have rejected knowledge. I reject you from being a priest to me. And since you have forgotten the law of your God, I also will forget your children. I just did a poll on Instagram asking you guys how many of you read the word regularly, daily. And I was pleasantly surprised that so many of you guys said that you did. But this is like what I could just harp on every single video, is read the word, be in the word. Don't try to put Christianity into culture, but view culture through the word and through faith in Jesus Christ. And it's not going to reconcile culture. It's not going to make it fit together. It just can't fit together, because following Jesus says it's the narrow road. Few will take that road, but it is the road that leads to life. And the ways of the world leads to death in the end. So, wow, that's ending a little bit on a downer. You guys, this is what I'm just so passionate about. This is what I have a huge heart for evangelism, for people to just have a strong-rooted faith in Jesus Christ that is unwavering, admits whatever culture says, because they go up and down with whatever is acceptable, but God's word stays the same no matter what. And I just want that strong foundation for people. And what I want even more than that is for people to experience the joy of the Lord. And that's why I share my story so much with you guys and the things I've gone through, because the joy of the Lord is found when we seek God and we come to God in the midst of our trials and we say, God, this is hard. This is rough. Like 2020 has been a rough year for so many of y'all. And when we seek God and we just come to Him and we surrender to Him and we let Him pour into us, that is when the joy of the Lord is filled up within us. And then we build on that joy over time. It's like, okay, I went through this trial and God got me through. So the next trial, God's gonna get me through. And you build that faith and you build that joy as time goes on. And I would love for so many of y'all who maybe feel like I don't have the joy of the Lord in my life. I don't have a love for His word. I'm struggling with my views about other Christians. I'm struggling with feeling disillusioned. I want you to experience that joy of the Lord in your life. So I just pray for that for you guys. I'm going to be praying for that for you all this week. I'm going to end this video now. I kind of went on a little rant here, a little tangent, but I had to answer that question, sharing with you guys what was on my heart. So don't forget, in the comments, share something about yourself. This has got to be a two-way question and answer, y'all. Share something about yourself or a topic you would like me to discuss in a future video. And I think I'm going to sign off. See you guys in my next video. Bye.